Right, so today we are going to discuss about the probability distribution. This is our 11th chapter, and this is quite a big chapter as well and a very testable area. So if you go through some past papers, you can see a total of one question has been formed from this chapter, right? Probability distribution, right? For 20 marks. ඔහුගේ පාස් පේපර්ස් දෙක තුනක් අරන් බැලුවොතින් හැම අවුරුද්දකම වගේ ලකුණු 20ක ප්‍රශ්නයක් මේ පාඩමෙන් ඇවිල්ලා තියෙනවා. Chapter number 11 under probability distributions. And there are several things we want to discuss under this chapter as well, right? So here are those things. So binomial probability distributions, Poissons. There are so many things we need to discuss. Right? Okay. Right. Probability distributions. So when you hear this word, probability, what comes to your mind? What does this word stands for? When I say probability, what comes to your mind? Probability කියන වචන හැදි ඔයගොල්ලෝට එන්නේ මොකද්ද? Probability, සම්භාවිතාව. But it is it is associated with uncertainty. Right? It means if we are not sure about something, in those situations, we use the concept of probability. Right? We may know the outcome. If we are uncertain about the outcome, in those occasions, we have to use, or we may use, probability. Right. So when talking about probability distributions, there are some key terms we want to be familiar with, right? Here, random variable and random experiment. Random experiment. Experiment we know, but why we use the word random here? I mean, random kele kele kudda gethi, right? In a certain experiment, if we are, what? Before doing that experiment, if we are not in a position to predict the exact outcome, apita experiment එක කරන්නේ නැතුව නැත්නම් experiment එක කරන්න කලින් එන outcome එක ගැන හරියටම කියන්න බැරි නම් right, that is what we call a random experiment. Without performing that experiment, we don't know what will be the outcome. For an example, rolling a die. දාතු කටියකට දාන්නේ. එතකොට අපි දන්නවා ඒක වෙන්නේ it will be either 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. But we don't know exactly what will be the outcome, right? Random experiment. And the random variable, these are two separate things, right? For an example, rolling a die, that is the experiment we are going to do, but we don't know the exact outcome. That is, therefore, we call such experiments as random experiment. So random variable means the outcome of it. If we are going to toss a coin, that is a random experiment. The random variables are either it will be head or it will be tail. If we take a roll in a die, that is our random experiment. The random variables means the outcomes of it. What? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. Random experiment and random variable. Right. Hope you know these two terms, discrete and continuous. Right. Random variables can be discrete random variables or can be continuous random variables. Me terms theka kalin hamba una. What do you mean by discrete? If I say discrete, what do you mean by that?
Specific value.
Yes. So random variables means the outcomes of our experiment. If those outcomes take some specific values, right? දාදු කටයකට දාද්දි හරියටම ස්පෙસિෆික් වැලියුස් මොනවද එක්කෝ එක නැත්තම් දෙක නැත්තම් තුන ඔය විදියට so it is a discrete random variable right if the outcomes of our experiment takes only some specific values those variables we identified as discrete random variables in the case if it can take any value right if it can take any value the possible outcomes If the possible outcomes can take any value, such random variables we identified as continuous random variables. Here, example given is what? The random experiment is measuring the lifetime of bulbs. Bulb එක ආයු කාලය මයින් එක තමයි random experiment එක. කරන්න කලින් දන්නේ නැහැ ආයු කාලය කීයක් වෙයිද කියලා. Random variable means the lifetime of a bulb in hours. පැය ගණන් වලින්. ඒක තමයි අපේ outcome එක. පැය 1යි, පැය 1යි විනාඩි 30යි, පැය 1යි විනාඩි 45යි ඔය විදිහට. Right? So what will be the values then? අපිට හරියටම පැයයි 2යි 3යි කියලා කියන්න පුළුවන්ද? බැ එක පැයයි විනාඩි 10ක් වෙන්නත් පුළුවන් පැයයි විනාඩි 20යි තප්පර 30ක් වෙන්නත් පුළුවන් ඒ විදිහට it can take any value so such variables we have to identify as continuous random variables right then we should have a clear cut understanding on this since we are discussing probability distributions we should know What does exactly a probability distribution is mean by? මොකද්ද මේ probability distribution එකක් කියලා කියන්නේ? ඔයාලට මතක ඇති when we talk about numerical distributions we should able to identify by looking at this distribution whether it is an individual data set whether it is a frequency distribution frequency එකත් එක ungroup the group එක කියලා අඳුනගන්න පුළුවන් වෙන්න ඕන. ඒ වගේම distribution එකක් දැක්කට පස්සේ අපිට අඳුන ගන්න පුළුවන් වෙන්න ඕන මේක probability distribution එකක්ද නැද්ද කියලා right so in order to identify or in order to form a probability distribution or in other terms a probability distribution means what a list of possible outcomes A list of possible outcomes should be there. අපි මොකක් හරි experiment එකක් කරනව නම් ඒ experiment එකෙන් එන outcomes ටික අපිට ලියා ගන්න පුළුවන් වෙන්න ඕන. Outcomes ටික අපිට පෙන්වන්න පුළුවන් වෙන්න ඕන. Right? A list of possible outcomes with their corresponding probabilities. Corresponding probabilities එක එක outcome එක එන්න තියෙන සම්භාවිතාව for an example if we are going to toss a coin so the outcomes are head and tail right so those are the possible outcomes and for each outcome we should able to identify the relevant or the corresponding probability for an example if we are going to toss a coin the probability of getting head is 0.5 the probability of getting tail is 0.5 like that way right with corresponding probabilities and the most important thing is the sum of probabilities should be equals to 1 possible outcomes tika penna tiyenna ona ekeka possible outcome ekata adala probabilities pennanna ona oya kiyana probabilities wala ekathuwa ekak wenna ona ehenam e wage distribution ekak we can identify as a probability distribution right this is very crucial the sum of probabilities should be equals to 1 in a probability distribution right okay we will move to example number 1 right example number 1 Okay, what it says. Example number one. Write down the probability distribution of tossing a six-sided die once. ප්‍රතිහයත් තියෙන ධාතු කටයක කොහොමද ධාතු කටයක ප්‍රතිහයයි ධාතු කටය පෙරලද්දී ඒකට අදාළ සම්භාවිතාව ව්‍යාප්තිය ලියන්නලු right we need to write down the probability distribution of tossing a six-sided die once right so if we want to form a probability distribution what we should have at first ඉස්සෙල්ලම අපි මොකක් දාගන්න ඕන මොනවද there should be a list of possible outcomes ටික පෙන්වන්න ඕන so in this experiment what are the possible outcomes in example number 1 මොනවද එන්න පුළුවන් possible outcomes ටික ධාතු කටිය පෙරලුවට පස්සේ 1 2 3 4 5 6 so these are the possible outcomes right
yes
and what is yes we have comply with the first criteria we have represent or we have showed a list of possible outcomes second point is what with their corresponding probabilities. එක එක outcome එකට අදාළ probabilities පෙන්වන්න ඕන. Right? එක එක outcome එකට අදාළ probabilities. Right. අපි ධාතු කැටයක් පෙරළුවට පස්සේ what is the probability of getting one? එක එන්න තියෙන සම්භාවිතාවය කීයද? කීයද? It is 1 over 6. හයෙන් එකක්.
එකක්.
Right? 1 over 6. 1 over 6.
Right. 6.
For 2, it is again 1 over 6. තුනේ එන්න තියෙන සම්භාවිතාවය 1 over 6. 1 over 6. Right? Like that. Right. The second criteria means this. Right? Possible outcomes ටික තියෙන්න ඕන. A list of possible outcomes. With their corresponding probabilities, what is the most important point? The sum of these probabilities should be equals to
1.
Right. Means probabilities will ekatuwa ekakata ekata samana wenna o. Right. So this is what we identify as a probability distribution. Right. This should be the answer for example number 1. Clear. Probability distribution එක. අපි අර මේක group frequency ද මේක ungroup frequency ද කියලා හඳුනගත්තා වගේ distribution එකක් දැක්කට පස්සේ අපිට කියන්න පුළුවන් වෙන්න ඕන මේක probability distribution එකක්ද නැද්ද කියලා. Right? Probability distribution එකක් වෙන්න නම් possible outcomes ටිකේ list එකක් තියෙන්න ඕන. එක එක outcome එකට අදාළ probabilities තියෙන්න ඕන. ඒ probabilities වල එකතුව අන්තිමට එකක් වෙන්න ඕන. Right. Okay. Clear. Example number 2.
2.
Write down the probability distribution of tossing a fair coin twice and getting hit. Right? Tossing a fair coin twice. That is our experiment. And getting hit. Right. We need to build up a probability distribution. කාසියක් දෙපාරක් උඩ දාලා අපිට head එන්න තියෙන සම්භාවිතාවයට අදාළ සම්භාවිතා ව්‍යාප්තිය දක්වන්න කියලා තියෙනවා. Right? We need to build up a probability distribution. Okay. How can we do this? Right? Right. If we are going to toss it for the first time, what will be our outcomes? Either it will be head or it will be tail.
Tail.
Okay. If you are going to toss it for the second time, පළවෙනි පාර head ඇවිල්ලා දෙවෙනි පාර toss කරද්දී අපිට head එන්න පුළුවන්. නැත්නම් tail එන්න probability එකක් තියෙනවා. Right? First time අපිට tail ඇවිල්ලා when we are tossing for the second time, we may get head or we may get tail. Right. This is what will happen, right? If we are tossing it for the first time and tossing it for the second time. First time and second time. Okay. What we going to measure? අපි මේ මොකද measure කරන්න යන්නේ? Tossing a fair coin twice and getting hit. Number of times we are getting hit. Number of times getting hit. කාසියක් අපි දෙපාරක් toss කරොතින් අපිට කී පාරක් head එයිද? Right? ඒකට අදාළ probability distribution we need to form. Right? In the first situation, how many times have we got head? First situation එක මොකද්ද? පළවෙනි පාර toss කරද්දි head ආව, දෙවෙනි පාර toss කරද්දි head ආව. අපිට එහෙනම් මේ experiment එකට අදාළව head කී පාරක් ඇවිල්ලා තියෙනවද? In first situation, two times we have got head, or the both times we have got head. In the second situation, first time we got head, second time we got tail. It means only one time we got head. Right? අපි මෙෂර් කරන්නේ මොකද්ද number of times getting hit right in third situation what has happened first time we got tail second time we got hit therefore number of times getting hit in the third situation is what only one time in the last situation first time we got hit and the second time also we got hit it means we have not get hit in any situation Right. So these are what? These are our, manavada. These are our possible outcomes, right? Possible outcomes. Right. Possible outcomes ke lapi hi nandaga ti manavada mitan. Number of times getting hit. Ek tamay apay variable lek. Number of times getting hit. Right. Okay, so what are the possible outcomes? What are the possible outcomes? Tika, khasiyak depara kura dammata passe apite ekavatavaka divat head en nathuwa tiyena puluwa right zero times or in one occasion or in only one time we may get head ekavatavaka di vitarak apite head enna puluwa naththam api khasiya uda dana devatavedima apite head enna puluwa right so these are the possible outcomes right Either it will be zero times, one time, or two times, right? And we need to know, or we need to show the respective or the corresponding probabilities of each of these possible outcomes. මේ එක එක outcome එකට අදාළ probabilities පෙන්වන්න පුළුවන් වෙන්න ඕන, right? එක වතාවකදීවත් හෙඩ් එන්නේ නැහැ that is our first situation first possible outcomes right we may not get head in any occasion so what is the probability මෙතනට එන්න ඕන probability එක කීයද there are four situations right look at this there are four situations in how many situations or occasions have we got this answer situations හතරක් තියෙනවා Situations happening. Yes, it means what? The probability should be 1/4, right? 1/4. Hatara vatavak outcomes hatara king. Ekka outcome hai kadi vitarai. Etang possibilities hatara king. Ekka possibility ka vitarai thi enne devatavam tail end. Etang head ekka vatavak pa enne netuva thi. Right? So the probability is 1/4. එක වතාවකදී විතරක් යනම් හෙඩ් එන තියෙන probability එක කීයද? Getting head only one time. What is the probability?
2/4. 2/4.
Right? 2/4. 2/4. It means 1/2. Right. In both situations, what is the probability of getting hit? කාසිය මේ toss කරන දෙවතාවෙ මේ head එන්න තියෙන සම්භාවිතාවය කීයද? Again, 1/4. List of possible outcomes with their corresponding probabilities. What was the other criteria? Probability distribution එකක් වෙන්න නම් possible outcomes ටික දැනගන්න ඕන. එක එක outcome එකට අදාළ probabilities පෙන්වන්න ඕන. What was the other thing?
Equal to someone.
Yes, the sum of probabilities should be equals to one. Right? So this yes. is this should be the answer for example number two. Right? Clear. Probability distribution. List of possible outcomes. With their corresponding probabilities, where the sum of probabilities should be equals to one. Right. Right here. Okay. We have measured what? We know how to calculate mean, median, mode, variance, standard deviations. Those statistical measures. When we are given with an individual data set or an ungrouped data set or a group frequency distribution, right? Individual data set එකක් දුන්නත් ungroup group දුන්නත් කොහොමද mean median mode variance calculate කරන්න කියලා අපි දැන් දන්නවා. Here in a probability distribution also we should know how to calculate mean variance and standard deviation, right? Probability distribution එකක උනත් ඒ කියන්නේ මේ වගේ distribution එකක උනත් කොහොමද mean එක calculate කරන්නේ කොහොමද variance එක calculate කරන්නේ කොහොමද standard deviation calculate කරන්නේ කියලා we should have an idea. Right. So this is the formula we use to calculate the mean of a probability distribution. Right. මේ වගේ සම්භාවිතා ව්‍යාප්තියක mean එක. Right. Mean value. Another word we use to identify the same is expected value. Expected value කිව්වත් එකයි mean කිව්වත් එකයි. Another word you know. And the term what? Average. Right. Both or all these terms means the same, right? Mean කිව්වත් එකයි, expected value කිව්වත් එකයි, average කිව්වත් එකයි, right? Okay. Example number 3. We are going to calculate the mean and standard deviation, right? The grade points and their probabilities in an accountancy course are as follows. Calculate the mean and standard deviation of this distribution. Right. Example number 3. Right. First of all, tell me whether it is a probability distribution. මේ දීලා තියෙන අපිට example number 3 වල මේ distribution එක probability distribution එකක්ද නැද්ද? Can we identify this distribution as a probability distribution?
Yes.
Yes. But list of possible outcomes is there. Right?
Yes.
List of possible outcomes.
Equal to some probability. What?
Yes. Right. So list of possible outcomes is there with their corresponding probabilities, and the most important thing is what? The sum of these probabilities should be equals to what?
Equal to 1.
Yes. Right. Can you remember the formula? How can we calculate the mean of a probability distribution? Abhi mean ne calculate kohomad? Mean?
Mean
equals to what? Mean equals to what?
Mean
equals sigma x into probabilities of x, right? Okay. So this is the formula sigma x into px. Now show me my x column. What is my x column? X column meka mukadda. We should have two columns. No? X into px. Yes. Grade point. This is my column X. Probability is, so this column should be my PX column. Probabilities of X, right? Probabilities of X, PX column, right? Then how can I calculate the mean there? Mata mean ne calculate puluwan kohomada ena? How?
X into PX.
X into PX, right?
PX.
Okay. X into PX, it means what? X value is 4. We need to multiply it by the probability of that value. PX, right? Here again, X into PX, right? X value is 2. PX value is 0.38. X into PX. X into PX. Again. X into PX. So what should be the mean value then? Mean value means the sum of this. That is why what we represent using sigma, right? Sigma X into PX. And 2.35 ke liye kyan ne me probability distribution ekata adala mean value ekak. Me ada api kiyanne anith nam mokadda? Average එහෙම නැත්නම් මොකද්ද expected value අපේක්ෂිත අගය right And we need to calculate what? Mean and standard deviation. Right? How can we calculate the standard deviation? Standard deviation calculate karna puluwan kohomada?
Sigma x into px.
Standard deviation. Standard deviation. Sigma what?
Standard deviation. Sigma x minus x bar.
Sigma x squared into px minus mu squared. Right? Minus mu squared. Yeah, it's mu. Right? Mu squared. So this is the formula we use to calculate the standard deviation. Sigma x squared into px minus mu squared. Right. X squared. X squared values sabhi calculate karna known, right? X squared 4 into 4 16 9 9 1 1 0 right. X squared calculate karatra passe mokadda wenna ona?
X squared into
xpx into px, right? X squared into px. X squared into px. This is my x squared column. I need to multiply it by the probabilities of x. X squared into px. X squared into px. Right? X squared into px. Right? X squared column make a very well known px column make it. Right? And we need to consider the sigma value of it. Sigma value, it means the sum of this, sum of x squared into px, this amount, right? 6.47, right? 6.47 minus what? Mu squared. What do you mean by mu? Mu means the mean. Mean we have already found. The mean value is 2.35 square value, right? Means again, we need to multiply it by 2.35. 0.9475. That is our standard deviation value. Right? Mean and the standard deviation. You know? Mean calculate mokadda api x column ekak danaganna ona probabilities of x column ekak danaganna ona, so we need to multiply those two, x into px. The sum we identified as the mean of our probability distribution. The standard deviation now we should know x squared values. Api x column ekak square karala ganna ona, varga karala we need to form a column, right? That x squared we need to multiply by probabilities of x. X squared into probabilities of x. Ethening apitenama mukadda sigma x squared into px. From that we need to deduct the square value of our mean. X square value deduct penna on. Right? That is example number 3. Right. This one. Example number 4. A discrete random variable M has the following probability distribution. Right? Okay. Values of X are given minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, and the probabilities of those X values are given. These are the things we need to determine. First, we need to determine the value of the constant M. M කියන constant එකට අදාළ මෙන්න මේ M වල value එක කීයද කියලා අහන්න. How can we find that? Right? කොහොමද යන්න පුළුවන්? example number 4. Right? Values of x. X column is given. Right? Minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, and 3. So these are our x values. So the outcome values. Right? Right. And the probabilities of x values also given. Probabilities m, right? Other one is 2m, again 2m, 3m, 4m, and 5m. M value how can we find the value of m here?
See the sum of the one, so
yes, right. What we know in terms of a probability distribution is there should be a list of possible outcomes, that is this column with their corresponding probabilities. It is also has been given. And what the other thing we know is the sum of the probabilities should be equals to
one.
Probabilities will ekatu ekak wenna ona probability distribution ekaka ena mokada wenna ona m plus 2m plus 2m plus 3m plus 4m plus 5m should be equals to what?
1.
Right? Okay. So here in my left hand side, what should be the total? 2, 2, 4, 7, 11, 16, 17. 17m equals to 1 nang. What should be the value of m? M will value kiyak wenna onada? M should be equals to what? Divide both sides by 17. It means 1 over 17. Right? The value of m is 1 over 17. That is, that should be the answer for part 1. Right? Part 1. Clear. Probability distribution ekaka probabilities wala ekathuwa hama tissema ekai. Ehenam menna me tika ekathu karata passe value ekak ekak wenno. Ehenam m wala value ekak kiya. Etakota me tika ekathu wenawa 17m. 17m should be equals to 1. It means m should be equals to 1 over 17. Right? Metana it is better to leave it as a fraction. Bhaga sankhyawak vidihata pennana eka metana hondai hetuwa meka hariyatama bedena gana nibe, right? We cannot exactly say if it is 1 over 4 metana m 1 over 4 awa kiyala hitanna. Etakota apita kiyanna puluwan mokadda hariyatama the value of m is 0.25. etanin ihata yanne naha. Eka finite, right? Etana hita apita nischithawa kiyanna puluwan. But here 1 over 17 e vidihata decimals gana nischithawa namathinne naha. It goes on and on. So in that situation, it is better to keep it as a fraction. නැත්තම් වෙන්නේ අපි කරන්නේ මොකද්ද? Round off කළා තමයි decimals ගන්න. Decimal points දෙකකට තුනකට round off කළා ගන්නවා. ගත්තට පස්සේ if we substitute those values here, the sum ultimately will not be equals to 1. Sum එක එකට සමාන වෙන්නේ නැත්තම් that we cannot identify as a probability distribution. That is why if you get an answer like this, keep it as a fraction, right? හරියටම decimals ගන්න අපිට කියන්න දන්නේ නැත්නම් ඒ answer එක හැමතිස්සෙම fraction එකක් විදිහට තියන්න. භාග සංඛ්‍යාවක් විදිහට තියන්න. Right. Part 2. What we need to find? Find probability of x being, what is this? X being less than 2. X වල අගය දෙකට වඩා අඩු ගානක් වෙන්න තියෙන සම්භාවිතාවය කීයද? Right? Probability of X being less than 2. X being less than 2 කිව්වොතින් X being less than 2 කිව්වොත් can I consider this minus 2 කියන figure එක දෙකට වඩා අඩුයිද වැඩියිද? මේ කන්ඩිෂන් එක සටිස්ෆයි කරනවද නැද්ද? If it is minus 2, can we consider? අපිට ඕන x වල අගය දෙකට වඩා අඩු අගයක් වෙන්න තියෙන සම්භාවිතාවය හොයන්න. Probability of x being less than 2. Right? Minus 2 is less than 2. So we can consider it. Minus 1 is also less than 2. So we can consider it as well. 0, yes, it is less than 2. 1 is also less than 2. මෙයාව ගන්න පුළුවන්ද? No, less than 2. දෙකට වඩා අඩුයි කිව්වොතින් we cannot consider the value of 2 and 3. So, the probability means what? The sum of these things. Right? M plus 2M plus 2M plus 3M. Right? Probability of x being less than 2 means m plus 2m plus 2m plus 3m. It means what? Should be equals to 8m. 8m, right. The value of m we know what? M වල value එක අපි දැන් හොයාගෙන තියෙන කීයද? 1 over 17.
1 over 17.
Right. එහෙනම් what should be the answer? දැන් අපිට හරියටම answer කියන්න පුළුවන්. කීයක් වෙන්න ඕනද? Right? 8 into 1 over 17. What? 8 over 70. Right? 8 over 70.